Hello everybody, welcome to this video. The last video I showed you was how to connect the Avroman bundle. In this video I'm going to show you how to use it with the XIZ stage. Now the full setup is connected, we can start performing our measurements. We're going to start with replacing the lens. This longer lens doesn't fit on this XYZ stage, so we have to replace it with a small one. Once the short lens is attached, we can attach the laser on the XYZ stage like this. Once the laser is attached on the XYZ stage, it's necessary to use the safety goggles at all time before turning on the laser.
If you want to perform a Raman measurement, you first have to start Avasoft software. Avasoft will show you several types of application buttons in the upper screen. If Raman Scope is not there yet, you have to install the plugin first. You can simply install the plugin by clicking on the File button and then go for the Tools for Plugin Accessories. You can now see two boxes, and the second box is the available plugins. You can select the Raman Scope and then click on the Install Plugin button to install it. After this is done, you can click OK, and now the application buttons in the upper screen will show Raman Scope as well. You can now start your Raman measurement.
Once we put on the safety goggles, we can turn on the laser. You see the light on. It shows the laser is active now. We can now proceed to calibrate the laser. We start with filling in the right wavelength in Avasoft.
In this case, we use 785 nanometers laser. When this number is filled in, it uses this value to calculate the Raman shift. Because small deviations are possible based on the laser, we have to calibrate the system to make it more accurate. After we put on the safety goggles, we can activate the laser. When the laser is enabled and the measurement started, it shows the Raman signal.
After we fill in the right wavelength in Avasoft, we use the PDFE sample to calibrate it to optimize our measurement. You can put the PDFE sample below the laser and can proceed with the calibration.
The laser is now focused on the PDFE tile, which is required for the wavelength calibration. After optimization, we first have to take a dark measurement by switching off the laser. When the peaks are disappeared, we can perform the dark measurement and can proceed to the scope minus dark mode. After enabling the laser again, we see the Raman signal left. We can now continue with the calibration of the laser wavelength. When the pop-up of the laser calibration opened, we can start the calibration measurement. It now measures the correct laser wavelength. As you can see, the measured wavelength is almost identical to the laser wavelength itself, and therefore ready to accept and proceed. Now the calibration is finished, your system has an accurate wavelength, and we can continue with measuring different samples.
Once the laser is calibrated, we can start perform the other samples. Medicines like aspirin, for example. To determine the positioning of your sample, you can use these two buttons, which are the X and I button. If you want to change the distance of the laser towards your sample, you can use this button, which is the Z button. The distance determined by the type of the sample you're measuring and the thickness.
When the other sample is placed, the laser can be switched back on and you can start measuring your sample. While optimizing the signal, we measure more and more signals. Now we see the signal is separated, so we have to change the settings of the spectrometer as well. Here we can auto-integrate to optimize our integration time. After setting the integration time again, we have to switch off the laser to perform a new dark measurement. After performing the dark measurement, the laser can be switched back on to proceed measuring other samples. In this case, the medicine aspirin. After finishing your measurement, you can save the data on your computer. It is possible to save your data in other file formats as well, ASCII for example. Each format can be used to upload the data to your data processing software to analyze the different peaks. If you want to measure a different sample, it is recommended to switch off the laser at all time. After this, we can replace the sample underneath the laser spot. In this case, we've changed the sample to titanium dioxide now. When you switch on the laser again, Avsoft shows a signal directly. In our case, it's the spectra of a titanium dioxide. This can be optimized by adjusting the height of the focal spot to the sample with the XIZ stage. Now we can create the optimal integration time for the sample measurement. Also, after changing the integration time, it is recommended to switch off the laser and perform a dark measurement first. When the dark measurement is finished, we can switch on the laser again. Now we can see a clear spectrum of titanium dioxide. You can save the spectra to your computer. And if required, the data can be saved in other file formats as well, ASCII for example.
Once your measurements are complete, you can turn off your system. First step is to put on the button on the front to deactivate the laser. The second step is to turn on the key at the back. And the last step is to take off your goggles. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for the next videos.